Teacher Jercel, how much is the per session?
Halika nga, tignan natin yung mga flyers. Because there, we have a lot of programs. So, like, ngayon is G-Force Project, no? That's the biggest and the grandest summer dance workshop here in the Philippines, and we're very happy. We are on our 16th year already. So, kaya hindi kita masagot kasi ang daming projects because there are a lot of requests. So, before G-Force Project, meron din darating ng mga performance 101, meron din kaming open classes dito. So,
For basic lang?
For basic, yeah. It's 550. Guys, help me with the details here. The open classes are, we need, yeah. Okay. Thank you so much. Okay. Ayan.
Tapos ilang session?
Open classes. No, for G-Force din tayo sa G-Force Project.
Okay.
Meron kami tinatawag na G-Treat. So, ito tapos na. We launched, we announced this 2 weeks ago. And it's a more, kumbaga parang, it's a treat. Okay? So, we have advanced payment and it says here 9,500. Yeah? So, April 17 to May 22. Maganda yan na deal. And then, of course, the regular payment, it's here.
What goes with the 9,000 something enrollment?
Okay, so it's a totally different experience. Not really, it's different because we share more than just dance. When you come in, it's not just about, you know, learning choreography, learning combination, yung ginawa ninyo kanina. It's really about character building. So the students for G-Force Project will commit to 6 days of workshop. For day one, they are usually assessed. The teachers will assess them. And then on day two, they will be given more challenging steps, more challenging choreography. Day three, yan na. Malalaman na natin ang groupings, and then the teachers will create their framework already until ma-prepare sila for their show. Now the show, we call it a dance concert because we mount it like a dance concert. It's not just a recital. Because, you know, they will be performing in these international venues. You know, we used to do this 4 years kami sa Araneta Coliseum, 4 years kami sa MOA Arena, thank you. And then, for the past 3-4 years also, we've been doing it at the Theater Soler. Kasi nga, it has gotten so big that we needed to break it down na to a concert series kasi bumaba yung show. Oo, kasi ang daming classes. So ang sabi namin, okay, since it's becoming bigger, i-divide na natin so that parents can really focus on the performances of their kids. So that's, it's really a whole experience. And we teach them discipline, camaraderie. They meet a lot of friends, new friends here. Pag mahiya, papasok lang dito, yung ibang parents, ginagawa kaming daycare. And which is okay because, you know, instead of their kids being so consumed by social media or gaming, at least they have this space for human connection. And it's very important, di ba, with the advancement of technology now. Saan ba tayo papunta? Kung hindi tayo, like kayo, like everyone, I'm also guilty with that. Nasa phone palagi. But what about real socializing, real connection? So this is also one space for them where they can, you know, socialize, meet a lot of people. And then, of course, resilience is also taught here. 1, 2, 3. Pagdating ng 4, medyo sumusuko ka na kasi nahihirapan ka na. So, but you have a goal. And that's where grit comes in naman. Diba? You have to finish and you have to do that goal. Resilience, nahihirapan ka, get up, overcome that whatever you are feeling. You have the support system of your classmates. Diba? So, those are the things that we give here. And most importantly, parang kayo, diba? Ang saya-saya nyo after nyo sumayaw. Kasi yun naman talaga ang ginagawa ng sayaw.
Yes.
When you, I always say, when you move, your brain goes into a happy mood. Especially now that, you know, hindi naman makaila sa atin na a lot of people are talking about mental wellness. And this is really, probably, I'd say the contribution of dance to the society. TikTok, sayawan tayo ng sayawan lahat, pinapasaya tayo. So, I think it is really a tool now. Really, this is a space for you to be happy. Come here, take our classes, you know, and you're gonna have a totally different experience because you come here, you find your sense of
belonging,
you come out having that sense of becoming. Yeah? So, pumasok ka dito mahiyain, paglabas mo,
walang hiya.
Kompem ka na. Yeah. Oh, and we have a lot of students who have that story.
So, apart from the happy place that you're offering, what certain fulfillment that did you acquire over the years that you
over
got
the years?
It?
Oh, yeah, because we have developed a lot of talents. Not just celebrities, but also teachers. The teachers of G-Force Dance Center, they are all homegrown teachers of G-Force. You know, like my daughter, my son, they grew up here. And then the G-Force also, and most of them are also students who have been trained to become performers and now trained to become teachers. And that's a you know, that you're really doing something that is fulfilling, not just for you but for them as well. But this year, you know, every year kasi may concept. Alam niyo yan, right? Like when we were in MOA, it's about painting new colors because it's our 11th year. Last year, we celebrated, nagdebo kami, 18th birthday, wow. Parang kanya na, yan, dumebo. So, nagdebo kami last year, and debo is, di ba, it's a ritual, no? Where you introduce the dalaga for the society, no? Na pwede na adulting na siya. So, kami naman ang G-Force, nagdebo kami, so it's a different, that means that we are entering a new phase, a new chapter in our lives. Now, 19 years. So what's our concept? Our concept is about moving forward with AI. AI is being discussed anywhere. Schools, businesses, also in social media, di ba, ina-AI yung mukha nyo? Na iba-iba yung mga naka-90s, preppy, varsity, may ganyan. So it's there. Actually, the future is now. It's here na eh. Do we turn our backs doon sa technology? Do we embrace it? Ano, are we ready to coexist? Paano ang dance pag may AI na? So, yun yung hinahanap namin ngayon. Na we also want to be with other people who are very curious with the new technology. How do we use this to our advantage? And will it benefit us or will it destroy us? So those are the things that we want to find out. And this year, we want to include that in our presentation. Lalem ha?
Serious kayo guys?
Serious. It's so hard to manage the school. Do you still teach?
I still teach, yes. I
masterclass.
Personally handle White Shirt Love. Yeah. That's the class that I really... kumbaga, ako talaga yung hands-on dyan. It's a dance fitness for women and women at heart. And this year we are celebrating its 10th anniversary. Yeah. So I will meet you again for that, ha? Oo, magkwentuhan tayo ulit for that. Kasi that is really a different program. It's for the women of age. And that's what I personally handle. And of course, the company classes here. Especially that we have new breed of teachers, new breed of dancers. Whenever I have time, our dance captain Bit and also our director Jelai schedules company class with Teacher G. And that's exclusively for the teachers and G-Force.
So with the advent of AI, what initial steps are you doing for you to be able to embrace it? Not to do away with it.
Say that again.
Not to do away with it.
Yeah. So the embrace is not yet there because we also want to learn more about it. We want to discover more about it. But what I really want to do right now is to include technology in our performances. But at the same time, I want to instill in the head of all the dancers who are here at GeForce Dance Center to really work on the capabilities of human. Ano ba yung capabilities natin at hindi kaya ituro ng teknolohiya? Kasi yun ang strength natin. You know, the articulation of our hands, hindi naman yan kaya ng technology. So, what else can we do? How can we, like for dancers, we're very articulate when we move and we tell a story. And AI, we don't know, can they do it? But as much as possible, really work on what we can do as humans. So it's really a tough, I mean, I don't have answers right now. That's why the question is, can we coexist
with
AI? I don't want to be scared because it's there na eh. Even us, we use it also. For intro ng mga production numbers, we don't have a voiceover talent. We don't have a host whenever we go abroad and we you know, like our global shows. We use AI and it's helping us. But pag may sumayaw na, saan kami pupuesto? Where do we position ourselves? So it's really about preparing the company to be future ready.
And how to stand out?
Well, more than standing out, we want to be future ready. Yeah. My questions, madalaga. I love it. Thank you. Thank you. Because, you know, it's really, ano eh, pinag-uusapan na yan eh. Diba sa eskwela, bawal.
But it's sad kasi AI is supposed to be created for the basic needs or basic chores for human, but now it has attacked the artistic side of human.
Yun dun matcha-challenge yung creativity natin. Do we treat it or do we look at it as an attack to our intelligence or do we use it to our advantage and really leverage pa what we can do? So that's where I'm coming from. I really don't wanna push it away, but will it benefit us? Probably, but will it destroy us? We can't tell. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Si Churchy, saan dito yung ano, BPOP naman?
OPM.
Or sasali siya sa, OPM?
OPM, yeah. We have a class here na focuses on OPM music only. Mm-hmm. So there's K-pop, right? Okay. Why can't we use our own music? So, yun naman talaga, at kasama ko ang mga teachers dito, number one si Teacher Jaja, na talaga nagpo-push ng OPM music. Yes, the OPM.
So, pero not necessarily K-pop?
Not parang necessarily K-pop.
OPM na parang ginawa nung dance.
It can be a song of, ano yung Raining in Manila, it can be that, it can be, Higa, it can be mga songs na hindi kailangan K-pop. We can, you know, they really choreograph to a lot of styles, a lot of sounds. Yeah. But again, we are pushing for the Filipino music. Especially, alam nyo, pag nagta-travel kami at nag-show kami sa labas. Kasi K-pop is like a movement na eh. We all, you know, I'm also an admirer of K-pop. No? But I also want to create something for us. Maybe it's a catalyst nga for us to push forward pa, to push for our, for what we have, di ba? Mm-hmm. Parang reminder, hey, kayo rin ha, mahusay naman kayo, pero i-push nyo pa, i-level up pa, yan.
So any song from P-pop that you're toying around to popularize in the future?
P-pop or OPM?
Like OPM.
In general, OPM. Okay, this is the song that my daughter taught me sa huli naming session. Wait lang. Let me.
Sasayaw
si. Ayan na. Ito. Ito yung pinaka-last. Oh, and the music of Skosta.
Yung lalap mo.
Kilala niyo siya? Skosta niya. Grabe yung mga music niya. X-Battalion music. Ganda rin. J-Roa. Oh, I listen to their songs. Ang huhusay! Okay. Shucks, nasan yun? I have a OPM playlist din. Ayan, see? Number one is Castagli. Ito, O-Side Mafia. Ayan. And that's Pinoy, ha? Oh. Diba? So ito yung huling session. It was Jaja, my daughter, who introduced this song to me. Diba? It's so nice. My thing. Just do my thing. Diba? Ah, bam! Ayan. So we're very excited for that. So, dami. So OPM music talaga. Alam mo yung magugulat ka na lang. Wow, Tagalog. Wow. Yan. Masaya, masaya, masaya. Happy ka doon.
How do you feel about yung surge din ng mga dance classes and becoming more popular because of TikTok?
Oo. Sobrang happy ko rin dyan. Alam mo, nag-start kami sa doon sa Mother Ignacia. That was our very first branch. When we started that, sabi ko, parang may struggle. Alam niyo, when I started my company, walang struggle. When I started GForce, walang struggle. Yung mga nagkukwento siya, I struggled, you know, when we were starting. Wala akong ganyan. Kasi, that was year 2005. I formed the company. I founded this company with, you know, dancers from different universities and colleges. They were all hungry. They were fresh. So, you know, the projects, nandiyan, left and right, nandiyan, pasok lang ng pasok, perform lang sila ng perform, right? And then, mag-shop sila kasi mga bata pa. But you know, when we started our own dance center, it was a struggle. Kasi parang you created a space na hindi, wala sa kultura ng mga Filipino to go to a dance class. Kasi diba, we dance anywhere. Di karaoke nga, diba? Kahit saan, kumakanta tayo, kahit sa shower. So same with dancing, parang in this, wala sa kultura na aralin siya. Well, except for ballet, di ba?
Yes.
But this one is, talagang kailangan namin pakita na inaaral. There is a method. Hindi lang kakopyahin yan sa ASAP, sa TV. May method. Maintindihan nyo saan kinukuha ang energy. So, with the presence of TikTok naman in our lives, ako natutuwa ako sa TikTok kasi it did not intimidate people to dance. Oo, parang lahat pwedeng sumayaw. Kasi pag nanonood kayo ng professional dancers for a show, wow, galing. Kasi dancers sila. But TikTok is, wow, galing. Sayaw tayo together. Yun yung, for me, yun yung happiness ng TikTok. And now, it's becoming like a part of the system na ng mga tao for them to come to classes, for them to study what's on TikTok. Ayan na.
How is that affecting you, teacher? Kasi parang before, parang pag gusto mong sumayaw, you need to, yun nga, enroll, join yung mga TV contest, dance contest. But now, people are, di ba, nasa TikTok na lang, doon na lang sila natututo, doon na lang sila
nagkakalap. You know, it did not affect us because the more they are on TikTok, the more that they come here.
Really?
Because they want to really dance.
Because they want to create content for
themselves. Yes, that's true. Parang kayo, ngayon, nandiyan yung mga cell phones, di ba? So sila rin, and to be, parang they like dancing here. They like this. They like this logo. When they dance here, it's becoming like they're content already.
But what I'm interested at is, you mentioned you did struggle.
No, nag-start. Sa
pero,
dance. Pero
nung
start ng dance center, may struggle.
But do you think struggle is necessary for you to succeed?
It is part of the learning curve. But not necessarily a necessity para mag-ganon. But you know, in every challenge naman, meron tayo talagang major learning. So I'm just so glad that, you know, dance is in the system of everyone.
Mas lumakas pa.
Mas lumakas, oo. Kasi they all, parang mas marami ang nagkaroon ng courage to dance. Mas marami ang hindi na nahihiya. Kayo, tanong ko kayo, you think kung in-invite kayo 2 years ago, gagawin niyo ba ito? Hindi, di ba? Kasi nakita niyo sa TikTok, ay kaya niya. Kaya ko rin. Yan. So, yun yung naibigay ng TikTok, right?
Yes. So, pandemic helped you?
Pandemic helped us. I'd say, yeah, because a lot of people embrace the movement. Yeah.
May mga ano ba, student sa summer project? Sa dance pa po ninyo ng summer na part na ngayon G-Force.
Yes, marami sila. Ang pinaka Teacher George, Teacher Micah. Yan, Teacher Micah was a student from our Shangri-La. Etsa Shangri-La, yes, the dentist. The Etsa Shangri-La workshop, wala pa kaming sariling dance center noon. 2011 when we had a partnership with Etsa Shangri-La Hotel, and Teacher Micah was a student there, Teacher George was a student there. So if I have given them that opportunity, why can't I give that to the new ones? The ones you saw earlier, Masa, Lorelaine, Sadie, and RC, they are all being trained to teach. In fact, they're offering classes already. We have, kumbaga, meron na sila mga hawak na classes also.
Sila yung ano, sila yung hindi pinapawisan, yung tayo, diba?
Fresh?
Parang walang nangyayari sa kanila. Part pa yun ng ano? Marketing. Yung
ba yung matututunan namin, how to be fresh?
Siguro part yung ano, pagiging G-Force, no?
Hindi pa tayo G-Force.
Hindi, kasi di ba pagbago sa inyo, nag-grind talaga yung utak. Kami rin naman, pumasok kami sa mundo nyo na nagbo-vlog. Effort yan sa amin because it's not automatic for us. So, pag pumasok kami sa mundo nyo, malamang ganun din yung powers namin. Pero kasi ito, they've been doing it na eh. Kumbaga nasa vocabulary na ng katawan nila yan.
Pero with the fitness, nakikilap po kayo. So, fitness regime yung mga dancer.
Fitness?
Like,
mayroon sa mga diet. Kasi the costumes will not adjust to their bodies. They have to they have to be fit. At saka more than the look, they have to be able to have that endurance para ma and stamina para ma magawa nila ng tama yung work. Yeah.
What do you think of the notion that I don't know if it's a misconception that dancing or the careers of dancers hindi pareho ng longevity ng singer because there's a physicality involved in dancing. Like Madonna is being bashed for her age. So why are you still dancing at your age? Gary, something, it's because he's a sing and dance act. Kaya he's, I don't know if the term is retiring. At least retiring from performing in big venues. What do you think of that?
Well, there's truth in that because science na yun and gravity. So even I experienced that. That's why here at G-Force Dance Center, here in G-Force, we treat talaga that dance career and here at G-Force, it's more than just dance. More than just dance for the students. I have given you already what's a concept of more than just dance. For the G-Force, it's more than just dance, meaning it's more than just performing. So when you come here, you will be trained to be a performer, and you will be trained to be a dance teacher, and you will be trained to be a choreographer. After that, you will also be trained to be a director, an artistic director here. So like me, I cannot do the dance of my kids. I am 40 plus. Nahirapan ako din sa But you know, like last year, I'll be honest with you, last year I felt the change in my body. So, the recovery is different na. Hindi katulad nung dati na may sasakit pero ang bilis. Ngayon, may sasakit, masakit pa rin. Natulog pa naman. Bakit? Masakit pa rin. So, ibang-iba na siya talaga ngayon. So, it's also how we take care of our body to have that yung sinasabi mo ang longevity. That's why here sa G-Force, ang entry talaga dito is 18 to 25. No? 25 to 35, dyan ka talaga nagmamature as a performer and as an artist. But 35 and you have to be really prepared na.
But meron ka bang student na 35 pataas na excellent?
Meron. Oo, meron. Pag excellent talaga, pwede nang jump up to performance or dance teacher.
How old pwede. Po yung pinaka-enroll?
Na nag-enroll? Meron kami ngayon, nag-open kami ng class exclusive or for them. For them. Mm. Kasi, ang hatak kasi ng GeForce talaga nasa mga Gen Z eh. Yeah. Oo, so may mga kaedad natin, papasok, no? Gusto lang sumayaw. We create a safe space. Hindi nyo ma-feel na talagang tinitingnan kayo ng mga bata, ay, ba't ko siya kasabay? Pero, siya mismo yung nakaka-feel na, ba't ako nandito? So, because of that, we created na lang adult classes. Especially for them. For 35 and up or 21 up. Teacher Sherwin, your classes, 21 up. Teacher Sherwin handles adult classes. Adult beginners hip-hop and also contemporary 18 up. So yan yon. Para wala mga 8 years old na kasabay nyo. Tapos kasabay nyo, mas magaling pa sa inyo. Diba? Nakakasira ng ego.
So there's no way around it, aging and dancing. Sabi mo na nga talagang it happens.
Pero no, but if you take care of yourself, walang problema. I can still dance, but there's acceptance na hindi ko na kaya yung ginagawa ko before.
So when
I can still dance.
I'm thinking na maybe if you had started earlier, we can still prolong.
You mean earlier and strengthening? Oh. Yeah, of course, of course. That's why now I've been doing
so
my therapy.
So it's better to start early. Yeah.
I've been, dapat by 35 pa lang, nagbubuhat na tayo, in-build na natin yung muscles natin. Yeah.
And what do you think of classes na ino-offer na for a certain song lang na nag-trend? I ask that kasi minsan iniisip ko when I see them, pinag-warm up ba sila? Or do they know na pag ganyang movement, if you're not properly trained, it could hurt you?
Importante talaga mag-warm up before doing choreographies. Mm. And the warm-up is designed depende sa movements na ibibigay sa inyo. Kasi like, if you guys will dance jazz, of course, the warm-up will be longer. And it's more intense.
Kasi sometimes you don't notice it when you're young. Sadang lang agad.
Yes. Kaya, if you notice our floor, I'm very big on this eh. Kailangan talaga strong core para masuportahan yung lower back and knees. Kaya, importante, we're very big on our floor. Even the upcoming branches, kailangan strong floor talaga. Kasi hindi pwedeng semento.
So do you frown on that or you favor that or wala na? Yung bang people just going to a class all of a sudden just because of a trend and then they don't know they might hurt themselves?
But you know, sometimes you can't avoid that eh. They just wanna dance. Like people who, yung mga sumasayaw sa streets, diba? Kaya nga siya street dance eh. They can't really demand for good facilities like this. Kaya naman, since nandito kami, we provide the facilities for that.
That's a difference.
But, you know, I cannot, like, say na, huy, wag yung gawin yan because saan sila sasayaw, diba? Kasi okay dito.
Is there a TikTok trend that made you think, uy, iba yun na, o mahirap yun, in terms of dance? Meron pa bang dance na sumikat sa TikTok na nakita mo na, uy, iba yun na, ang hirap mo?
Wala. So I need like more hours for that.
So you have made a lot of signature moves popular, no?
Thank you.
Kasi pag songwriting sinusulat, paano pag choreography? Do you write the steps?
Do I write it?
Take videos.
She writes it in her brain.
Muscle memory.
Well, kasi iba na rin yung process. Iba na yung process eh, over the years. Iba na. Right now kasi, before it's always, you know, when I choreograph, it's always by feel, no? By feel. And then, thanks to all the phone cameras that I get to record myself and then study it at home And then you check, visually effective ba siya? Masarap siya sa yawer, pero masarap pa siyang panoorin. Is it visually effective? So, buti na lang may cellphone na. Imagine mo dati pa ulit-ulit lang yung dancers ko, sino pa ako happy sa movement. So, pagod talaga lahat. So, kumbaga, it's a...
May playback.
Yes, may playback. So, meron kaming na-document na. Before kasi, it's just all here and also muscle memory. So, again, this is how we use the technology. And I'm very happy, diba?
Teacher, may sita ba dun sa, for example, bago ituro ng mga teachers mo, yung choreography, may touch ko or sinishat yung...
When it is handed to a celebrity, especially if it's going to be a song of their own. Yes, that is our process. They submit, it's like an audition. Ang pinakahuli namin ginawa is Sugal by Maha. That's early this year. So, three choreographers submitted, and then from there, it's like an audition to check and work, and then may pumasaba, and then when I need to hands-on, I will really hands-on. For that one, like hands-on ako.
So, paano bayaran niya? When you have that certain project.
Yeah. So, di ba, kanina nahirapan akong sumagot sa'yo because, you know, we have the management to take care of that. Kaya tinatawag ko sila, hey, can you help me with this? Tapos magbabasa lang ako. Because we have a management who will take care of that. We have a finance team for that.
So, tanongin mo,
kasi parang pagsiyari mo, of course,